This is the one I've got a really bad feeling about going onto my neighbor's roof right there. That's why I don't have the car in the driveway. Just in case. Man, that's a... These are some nasty trees. They're just terrible. Well, this is our place. Let me see, you get the date up here. There you go, January 8th. There's one branch down. That's what our neighborhood looks like. You can hear the trees all cracking. That's Rudy's tree. There's trees in the middle of the road. All kinds of stuff. It's a real mess. That's where the tree fell down on our house. Over there. There's a lot of branches around. Yeah, the Hepburn's tree is a real mess. As you can see, it's all cracked up. Pretty incredible. You can see all these branches are just incredible. We don't have any power today, so at least not. Well, here we are on January the 10th. That's a tree in our front yard. That's our front yard. There's our house there. And there's Stoop. Look at that, eh? It's incredible, all these trees like this. Branches down everywhere. Still sort of have to finish the driveway. Bit of a mess. And that's Rudy's tree there. This is really toast. Nothing left there. Real mess is at the Hepburns over here. They've got almost all of their trees are down. And that's the big maple tree in their backyard. You can see that it's in pretty rough shape. Some of it's on the house. That part there slid down the roof and onto the yard. But they've got some hanging over top of their house too, and the whole front of their house is really a mess, all the trees that are out there. That's the sound of melting ice falling off the trees now for a change. See, our whole street's just in terrible shape. Chunks of ice falling everywhere. Which means I guess I should be standing under this tree. There's our house. I suspect it's going to look really empty this year because, well, maybe they can salvage ours. There's many that they can't, though. Some of them are in really bad shape, so. That's it. That's it, that's all. I still have to finish the driveway. It's just covered in ice. There's a good 2 inches of ice, but it's pretty soft now. Hey, Puck. Yeah. There you are. Hey, puppy. That's kind of different sound. You can hear birds. I think that's... I can't see it from here, but the Zoom will tell us what that is. Ouch! Ow! Jeez, that hurt. Oh, man. So you don't stand under trees with ice on them. That's smarts. I don't know what kind of bird that is. We'll see it on the video, I'll be able to tell then. Oh, I hear more coming down. I'm gonna get out of here. Bonked on the head one too many times, I'm gonna know about it. There we go. Okay, back into the... Here we are back outside the house, and I've chopped up a lot of the branches that were down around the tree. There's still like lots. You can see how much damage there was. And then I removed the stuff that was on the roof. But yeah, pretty amazing stuff. We got a big bundle of trees here. See how the one on top of the roof there earlier, and there's that one branch that's still sticking out, but doesn't appear to be any damage on the roof, I don't think. There's still quite a bit of ice on there, so hopefully nothing happened. And heifers have got a real mess on their hands. Probably try and get some stuff done for them too, but I'm gonna go to work today. You hear chainsaws in the distance. In our house. Oh, there you go. And that should be the end of the catastrophe, I think.